Hi everybody, welcome to Create with Ella, and I'm Ella. Today is Monday, December 5th, and we are going to be working on a Christmas gift for one of my family members. They don't watch my show, so we're safe. there's my little thing. So today, that's what we're going to be doing. This is a live show with a live chat for those who are watching on Ustream. And if we get to a point or place in the show where you're like, okay, seen enough, then, you know, please feel free to fast forward. We don't mind at all. We completely understand. And, if you do like the YouTube that you're watching, please give me a thumbs up. We're here every Monday at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, and we have people joining us from all over the world. There's Jean. Jean's making a beautiful photo album for her mother, and that's where we were just at, watching her do that. So we're all in the throes of Christmas. Making things here and there for different people and just having a grand time. So if you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm going to be working with mediums today, gesso, paint, you know, stuff like that. So I just put on some gloves in a bottle. It's a shielding lotion. Jean says, my family doesn't watch my show either because I have never showed them how to find me. They don't even know my YouTube. You guys are my family, and I'm not sharing. You guys are mine. I am not sharing you with my family. Well, thank you, Jean. The only one that would watch my show is my mother, and I have told her about it. But my mother, my mother is way too busy to sit and watch my Ustream show. She would tell me, I love you, but I got other things I need to be doing. So, you know, I send her pictures and she's thrilled to death. Or she sees it on my Facebook page. Anyway, getting back to this. This is gloves in a bottle. It's like wearing an invisible pair of gloves. It shields your hands in that when you finish working with your gesso or your paint or whatever medium it is that's all over your hands, you can go in the restroom and it wash your hands and it comes off very easy. It's almost like it was never on there. I normally don't wear it because I have a Ranger scrubber that takes all that stuff off super easy. But today I'm working with black gesso and I did not want to be walking around with black gesso on my hands because sometimes, you know, it will stain your hands or something like that. So what we're going to be doing today is I've got my mat down because I don't want to get this on my desk, but this is a Prima art frame. It's just a regular frame, resin frame, and it comes two in a pack, this one and a smaller one. Yes, gesso does come in black. And then these are Sandra Everston, who is a designer for Prima. These are her artifacts. And when I went to Prima Adventure this past January, we worked with these and made a beautiful necklace. So I'm going to be using that and some heavy black gesso. It's a Finnebars. Art Basics heavy gesso in black, and we are going to be using some Art Alchemy by Finnebar acrylic paint. This is Opal Magic. Well, it's called Opal Magic. This color is blue gold, and this color is green gold. And when you put them on there, they come out different when you put them on black gesso versus white, or when you put them on black, they come out different. At Art Venture, we made this clock, and next year I'm going to be making another one of these for a gift. And you can see in here where we used the green gold. You can see where it's touched of green right in here. And so all these flowers were all different colors and the metals and everything. And we covered everything in black gesso. And then we added different mediums to get these colors. Like this color here is this, I don't know if it'll show up on camera, but it's like a purplish color right here. And that is from this color. So that's what we're going to be doing today. I have not practiced. I have my apron on because I don't want to mess up my clothes. I usually don't wear an apron because I have grungy clothes on. But today I have new grungy clothes on and I don't want to mess up my new grungy clothes. So the first thing we have to do is we have to paint these with black gesso. So I have an old brush here that I only use for, it's one of the ones I use for gesso. And I have some water. But before we get started, I wanted to show you one thing. Remember the jars I made for my friend here that lives on the beach? I mean, that loves the beach. And I made these three jars using mason jars for her to use on her patio when she entertained, or she could use them inside her home. And remember, we painted them with Mod Podge aquamarine transparent, translucent, transparent paint. And they were real, you couldn't see through them. And I was like, oh, maybe I messed this up. Well, 2 days later, and here's what they look like. So I still have to go and do some touch up with the strings. I haven't got that far yet, but that'll only take a couple of minutes. But I'm very happy with the way they turned out. You can see how transparent they are. If you look, you can see my hand down at the bottom. And so I think they turned out real pretty. And they'll look really nice either in her house or outside on her patio when she entertains. Oh, I don't know what I said. I've said it for years. Whatever I said, Mod Podge. I might have said Modge Podge. I don't know, but it was Mod Podge Aqua. I think they called it translucent paint. And so what I'm going to do is put the white sand in a little resealable bag and put that inside with the flameless tea light, you know, that operates on a battery, and put that inside. So I made, remember, I made this one and two small ones. And I didn't either, Debbie. I was a little concerned because I know it's my southern accent, Modge Podge. But I know it's Mod Podge. It's just my southern. I run it all together. I had put them in the garage on a rack and turned them upside down, like they said, and left them out there overnight. But when I went out the next morning, they still were rather milky. And I thought, oh, I totally, that's not the effect I wanted. Maybe I put it on wrong. So I brought them inside the house, and I'm located in Oxnard, California, between Santa Barbara and Malibu, but I'm originally from Charleston, South Carolina. So that's where I get my southern accent from. So I brought them in the house, and I put them on this mat and put them on my dining room table in the sunny window. And all day long, I kept going in there and they were changing. They were getting clearer and clearer and clearer. So I'm just real, real, real happy with them, how they turned out. And I think she's really going to like them a lot. But you can see, if you look in there, you can see they're very translucent, lucent. But yeah, can you see my hand in there? See how clear they look? See if I can put it on autofocus. And you can get an idea. Can you see my hand in there? That's how clear they are. They're so pretty. Yeah, Mod Podge. Okay, I just wanted to show y'all that because when we left last week, they were still wet. So that's where that is. So I got my stuff on my hands, and now I'm going to paint these elements black with black gesso. And the first thing, when you buy these, they come with these little hooks, eye hooks. So if you want to make a necklace or something, there's already there. But I'm going to put these on top of one another. So I'm just going to take this eye hook out. They're very easy to take out. They just unscrew, and then it will go on top like that. So, gesso is kind of thick. So, you don't need a lot. It covers really well. And I wanted to mention that if you want to ask me a question, please type in all caps. Or if you want to point something out to me, if you're addressing me in any way, please type in all caps. That way, when I look up at the chat, I can see right away if there's a question or a comment or something for me. Okay? And I appreciate that. So we're going to paint inside this little opening here. And I think, oopsie, I didn't get it down there. It's important for this project that all areas, the sides are covered, not the back, but the sides. Okay. So if you are new to using different mediums for your gesso, black or sand or whatever type, you want to have a dedicated brush. You do not want, because it'll ruin your brushes. This brush will go immediately into a jar of water I have over here on my desk. And then after the show, I will rinse the brush out. But you don't want to use a good brush because the gesso will ruin it. So most of us, I think pretty much all of us, have a dedicated gesso brush. So I'm just, making sure I get in all these little crevices. It doesn't take gesso very long to dry, but I'm going to speed it up and use a heat gun. Oh no, Debbie. Well, I've had this since, did you leave this lid on this here, the protection, the protector lid? I think mine's still pretty good. I haven't used it since January at Art Venture, but it appears to be pretty good. But so many things affect our mediums, where we live, where we store our stuff, if it's stored in a real cold place or inside of a warm house or okay, and then now I'm going to paint. Move that over there. And what I'm going to do is this will sit on an easel. Yes, what I'm thinking, Jean. This will sit on an easel. And you'll see when we start putting it together. I left this protector where it says sealed for your protection. I left that on there But if you lose that, you can always put a piece of wax, not wax, you can put a piece of saran wrap or something of that nature on it and then secure it with the lid. Oh, you never opened it? Did you have it in a cold place? Because one lady last week was telling us she had her something. I forget. Does anybody remember what she had stored out in a storage shed and it got down to very, very cold and it ruined it? I forgot what it was, but maybe glossy accents or Fabri-Tac or something. But they don't like, none of them like very cold weather. None of the mediums. So if you live in a place where it gets very, 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 very cold, and by that I mean somewhere like where Jean lives, that's very cold to me. I wouldn't leave it stored in my garage. Or if you live up north, I wouldn't leave it stored in my garage. Oh, it was room temperature. Oh, wow, I don't know. How long have you had it? Yeah, anything acrylic will freeze. Yeah. Did you have it there? Have you had it very long, Debbie? Like I said, I haven't done a practice on this. The last time I worked with these mediums was back in January, so if this doesn't turn out, I have a backup plan for this person, this family member. This is for my mother. Oh, you had it about a year. Too bad you didn't realize that earlier because you probably could have returned it. I mean, I know some of the ladies had horrible problems with some of the dilution paints, and they contacted them and they sent them new ones. There were two colors that people had a really hard time with. I don't have any dilutions paint, so I don't know about that, but I know a lot of people had, there were two colors that people were having a horrible time with. Oh, that's a good point, Jane. Jean said if you ordered it from somebody up north, it might have froze before you got it on the way to you or something. It was free from Deco Art Helping Artist. Oh, okay. Oh yeah, the pink and purple. That's right, Jean. The pink and purple dilutions ink from the first batch, all of it was goopy and got replaced. That's right, the pink and purple. So I don't want any of the white to show on the sides or front, and then on the back, There will be eventually there will be a piece of paper attached to the bat. I don't know if we'll get that far today because I haven't picked out the paper, but I have in my mind what everything else I want to do. That's right. They still have issues with the lids leaking during transport on planes. Yeah. Who are you guys talking about in the chat that had a brain blood stroke? Do I know her? Regardless, I'll be praying for her and her family. Was it someone in Gia's family? Jillian's family? So I'm holding it up to make sure that, who are you talking about? Oh, Met wife Teresa. She had a brain blood stroke. Is that what you guys said? No. Okay, let me see if I can get in here with. This is why another reason you don't want to use your good brush because sometimes you have to get down in the crevices, and in order to do that, you have to sometimes treat your brushes kind of harshly. Oh, Jillian had surgery today for colon cancer. Oh my gosh. God bless her. Hope speedy recovery to her and wisdom and insight for her medical team. Got that little white spot in there. Yeah, I think we got all the space areas covered. Once everything is dry completely, I can go around and look, see if I missed any places, and use a smaller brush to get in there. See, this piece over here is just about dry. On, get in there. To just put a little bit more on my brush. There you go. So when you're working with something like this and you're trying to cover up another color like me with the white, you want to continuously turn your piece to make sure you've got everything, covered. And then, like I said, once it is dry and you can pick it up and see. So right now I'm going to cover this. I'm going to close this back. There you go. I'm going to get a baby wipe and just wipe this off my hands. See how that just comes right off with the baby wipe because I've got the gloves on. Isn't that great? I love it. And then I have acrylic, I have gel nails. These are my real fingernails, but I get gel polish on them because I'm so hard on my fingernails with paper and everything that they and the manicure just lasts longer. But this won't hurt my nails either. So see, look, isn't that great? Just plain old baby wipe. And then it'll come off my mat the same way because, you know, mat is non-stick. When we were at Art Venture, I didn't bring my gloves with this stuff with me, and but it does, like I said, it doesn't bother me like it does some people. And we would go out to eat and we'd have green hands and, you know, just all kind of crazy colored hands because we've been working with all kind of crazy mediums. And people say, "Oh, are you an artist?" And we're like, "Yes." Which is true, we were. Just probably not the kind they were thinking about. Okay, so I'll put that there. And okay, noise pollution. Excuse me. Okay, Jean. Okay, so I can see where I've missed a couple of spots. So I'm gonna get a smaller brush and go over those spots. Now, this brush that I'm gonna use is a brush designed by Finnebar, distributed by Prima under Art Basics. And this brush is designed to work with all kind of mediums. But again, as you can see, it's got black gesso all over it because that's what we did in class. But again, when I finish with it, I will put it right into water. Because if I were to leave it out of water or go clean it right away, it would ruin the brush. So, how's everybody doing with their shopping for their gifts or making their gifts? Are you on schedule, on target? Do you need help from the elves? I'm in pretty good shape. I'm going to a crop this weekend for 2 days, all day Friday and all day Saturday, from 10 to midnight both days. And I've got my projects lined up to do for that. I just have to do some cutting before I go, so I don't have to take as much. So Debbie said she uses Murphy's oil on her acrylic and glue black brushes to clean them. Yeah, I have Murphy's oil. That's a good point. Thank you, Debbie, for sharing that. That'll definitely work. I'm not going to worry about the inside because there's something I want to put on the inside, and so it's not going to show anyway. But I already got a little bit in there, so I'll just go ahead and spread that out. So then next week I have to get everything in the mail, because we will be traveling on the 20th. Okay, I think that's about as good as. I think that's good. By the time I put everything else on there, you'll never know. Okay. Seal this back up. And use our noise polluter. Okay, so I'm gonna set these aside while I clean my mat before we go to the next step. You're on YouTube watching, just fast forward. Gotta clean this off. I buy the cheapest baby wipes I can find, usually from the dollar store. You don't want a lot of lanolin in them, especially if you're going to be using them to wipe back paint on your Oh, thank you, Jennifer. That was a lot of fun. I'm gonna be making another one of those next year as a gift, so you'll get to see that whole process. I was in that class with Zandra, and we had a great time making that clock. That's where the lady accused me of stealing the brushes, her brushes, because you pay a lot of money. So worth it though to go to Prima Art Venture and you get a whole set. We got a whole set of Finnebar's brushes, right? And this lady lost one, And I happened to be the dearest one sitting next to her. And she accused me of stealing her brush. And I said, I don't have your brush. You know, maybe you ought to look down in your bag. Maybe it rolled off the table into your bag. No, no, I've already looked. You need to empty your bag out and look, because I think you have my brush. Yeah, you remember her, Bunny? And I said, I have already looked, and I don't have your brush. I said, my gosh, just go up there and tell them that you lost your brush. I'm sure they will give you another one. And she just kept on and 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 on about it. And finally, I turned to her and I said, lady, I don't have your flipping brush. You are getting on my last nerve. And Finnebar was teaching the class, and she came over there and she said, now, now, ladies, what's going on? And I said, she's accusing me of stealing her brush. I don't have her brush. I've looked in my bag. Now she's demanding I dump everything out of my bag again. And I'm not doing it because I don't have her brush. And, you know, she's getting on my last nerve here. I'm done with her. So she said, oh, we'll give you another brush. Don't worry about it. And she gave the lady another brush. So right now I'm going to use 3D gloss gel, transparent. And I'm going to do that because I want to seal these in case I want to use another medium over them. I'll be able to see I missed some right there, but I will get that. I probably ought to get that now, huh? No, I can. Let me get it. Oh my gosh, y'all, I'm not going to believe what I did. Good thing I was through with my peppermint mocha. I put my brush into the peppermint mocha cup. So let me share this with you guys. I get this magazine from Paper Source, right? I love Paper Source. They have one about 20 to 25 miles from my house. And this little bookmark right here says, when something goes wrong in your life, just yell, plot twist and move on. Plot twist and move on. Oh, I thought that was pretty good. Okay, so this I do need to fix. See that right there? Because that's going to show. Yeah, that lady was a trip, man. I know you have my brush. I don't have your brush, lady. So I'm just touching up the edges here. Okay, so that's good. Make sure. That's good. Oops, quite a bit over here. See, now that it's dry, I can pick it up and without getting a whole lot of stuff on my hands. Oh, nope, never did. Never apologized, never nothing. They gave her not just the one brush she lost, but they gave her a whole new set of brushes. But she never found, I don't know if she ever found it, but she never apologized to me. She was something to behold, let me tell you.
Okay.
Okay, one more time with the heat gun. Or as Jen calls it, the noise polluter. So I got this idea for this from Pinterest. If you type in artifacts and relics by Sandra, or artifacts and relics Prima, you'll get all kind of, you'll see all kind of beautiful things. They were designed by Sandra Everston, who is a designer for, at the time was a designer for Prima. And they are replicas of original pieces she has collected from all over the world. So now I need to get a brush to apply that with. And I'm going to use another one of Finnebar's brushes because, like I said, these are designed to work with all the mediums. And they won't be destroyed. So I'm just going to put some out on my mat here. And this is, again, 3D Gloss Transparent Gel. Art Basics by Finnebar. Distributed by Prima. Yeah, Debbie, it was. It was. She was something else, let me tell you. And, you know, most people in that class are so helpful in those type of classes. They're so helpful. You know, and here, use mine, you know, and then you give it back. And not her, buddy. She just knew I had it. And then she just demanded, I demand, she said, you need to empty your bag out right now. I said, nope, not going to happen. I've already looked, I've already done that, I don't have it. Well, I think you need to do it again. I said, well, too bad, I'm not doing it again. Yeah, and we paid a lot for those classes. Like I said, it was well worth every penny, in my opinion. We had a great time. We got as much in product as we paid for the class, if not more. I'm not able to go this coming year because of other commitments that I have. But Sandra is going. And this year, it's in, next year, it's in Phoenix. It's not in L.A., Now, if you don't want a matte finish, if you don't want a glossy finish, then don't use this because this is a gloss gel. But I want this to be glossy. You know, it just depends on the piece you're making. And the preference of the person you're making things for. Yeah, I did call her Miss Thang, didn't I? She was definitely a piece of work. You can see, you know, I'm not putting a bunch on here. I'm, It is going down in the crevices, but I'm using my brush to get big globs of it out of there. And now we can use this piece. No, I'm not, Jennifer. I'm not. I have too many, I guess some hot glue strings, too many other financial commitments to be able to go to Maryland. I don't mean in way of bills. I just mean, going different places. I hope to get there one day. Hopefully, Patty will keep doing it for several more years. I think Sandra's gonna go if she heals, she may have to be having knee surgery. So it depends upon when she has her surgery, because I know she wants to go. So what I do is I just take my brush and push this back in and tap it down. Usually it goes right back in there. And then I like to clean off the lid because I don't want all that. I don't like it to get stuck. Yeah, I know what you mean, Debbie. I'm way on the West Coast for so for me to get over there and on the airline and then, pay for everything. It's a big chunk of change. And there's some other things I have on the agenda. I did see that, Jennifer. I did see that. Oh yeah, that does, yeah. Definitely, Debbie. That does kind of offset things. Oh, what's that? Hot glue. Man, I got hot glue strings everywhere. Don't want to hold this right down on the gesso or the gel because sometimes it will bubble. So you don't want to hold it too close. Hi, Jen. We're working with some black gesso. And some 3D gloss transparent gel. And some Prima art relic pieces. This is a Christmas gift. This one's almost dry. And be careful when you finish drying them, because sometimes they will be hot to the touch. Oh, she says. They have to be dry before I can go to the next step. So these corners is what I'm drawing right now. This piece is pretty much dry, and this piece too. It's just in the crevices. It takes a little longer to dry. Hi, CB. Oh, good. Firefox to the rescue. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this piece aside and let it dry on its own for a while, and we're going to go to this piece. Now, these colors in here, these are Art Alchemy by Finnebar. This acrylic paint is called, it's Opal Magic, and this is green gold, and this is blue gold. Now, they come out different colors when you put them on different papers and different mediums. So on black, I think it's this one that turns purple. So we are going to see. I'm going to shake them up a little bit. Okay, so they're real yummy. So let's go with, oh, you have these on your Amazon list? Okay, so let's make sure this is dry, and it is. And we're going to see how they do. Now, see, this one turns gold. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? And this was the blue gold. So on black, it turns gold. And I don't want to completely cover it in gold. In fact, I want to wipe some of that back. So let's see if I can do that since I put that on there. Nope, once it's on there, it's on there. Okay. That's okay. Okay, so now let's see what color the green will turn, because I forget. Oh, is the green the one I just used? Must be. Well, let's see what color the blue turns. The blue turns gold. That's what I thought. They're supposed to turn different colors. But it's okay. I like the gold. It might be because I put the I do too, Eileen. It might be because I put the gosh, I can't even think. Gloss gel on it. Okay, so that's that color. So we're gonna let that sit there for a few minutes. This one's dry. And I'm just barely putting my brush in there. I don't want complete coverage. I just want a hint of it. Can you see the, see if I can get it to autofocus. There you go. Thanks, Jen. I'm gonna go ahead and do this one. And where it is, not dry, I'll bring you guys in some. I'll try not to get in there. So right in here, I just want a little bit of this color. So I'm just barely just scratching, you know. I like to go light first. I like to be light-handed at first, and then I can always go back and add more. But you can't take away too much. So see, I'm not applying any more paint to my brush. Thank you, Bunny. I'm just using what's on there. Okay. Now, this next little thing, I'm trying to get these back down in there. I don't know if this is going to work or not, but I thought, what the heck? We're going to try it. The inspiration piece had some silver in here, and I don't have anything in silver except this dabber. So I thought I would try this dabber dauber. Silver. Oh, good. Good, Jean. And want to see how that's gonna look. Oh, look at that. Oh. Look at that. No, Tuesday, tomorrow, I mean Wednesday, we're meeting up. Yesterday was her birthday. So, I had to get on her calendar and she worked me in for Wednesday. So, I'm just going around here sporadically. There's no rhyme or reason to what I'm doing. Oh, yeah, I'll show them to you, CB. For those of you that missed it, here's the jars. And you can see how translucent they are. You can see my hand in there. Remember, they were real milky before? So I'm going to put the sand in, come on, a little baggie and put it in there with the battery operated tea light. And then she can put them on her patio and they'll be really pretty. Yeah, she's a busy bee, this lady. She's kind of funny, but she grew up here. She was born and raised here, and she has been to every high school reunion, and she has a lot of, she's retired, so she has a lot of friends from work. She has a lot of bunco friends. She has a lot of high school friends, wine drinking friends, scrapbook friends. You name it, she's got it, right? So, yeah. I know it sounds funny, doesn't it? That's her. So I was able to get some of that and rub that off. So that's good. I had a little bit too much there. I knew I wouldn't be able to get with her on her birthday because she was going to the winery with some friends and out to eat and all of that stuff. Yeah, they did. What happened was I put them in the garage, right? After class, I put them on a rack and turned them upside down like it said. And I went out there the next morning and they were still, like I had left them. And I thought, oh, I messed this up. So I brought them in the house and with the rack and everything and put them on my dining room table. And by the end of the day, they had already started turning, I mean, getting clearer. And by the next day, they were completely finished. So it took 2 whole days for them to get to where I wanted them to be. Okay, so now I'm going to put some silver on this one. And this is Adirondack metallics, acrylic paint, dabber, and silver. And I'm just going back and forth because I don't want it to look, you know, too even. Yeah, I'm very happy with the way they turned out. I'm very happy. Yeah, it took 2 days. And you know, when I saw how thick the thick it was, I thought, oh, you know, come on. But it, I mean, it did say, you know, it would take time for it to dry. And okay, I was fine with that. But when I got up the next morning, yes, it would be. And this is what I used. Mod Podge Sheer Aqua Turquoise Transparent Paint. Oops, sorry. Mod Podge Sheer Aqua Turquoise Transparent Water-based sealer, glue and finish color for glass, wood, and paper. And it took 3/4 of a jar to do those 3 jars. And you know, I thought, oh, it's not going to be. Where do the 2 ornaments come from? This is all from Prima. It's part of the Relics and Artifacts collection. Designed by Sandra Everston. Okay, noise pollution. Yeah, Jean, that would be very pretty. Red or green. Okay, so I think I want another color on here. And I have this broken china distress paint, dabber. Broken china. So we'll see how this, I'm gonna give it a touch of blue and see how this will do, how this is gonna look. Brush and water. Okay, so where's the lid? I'm not a little crazy about that right there. Yeah, that's true. Look at me. I put the wrong end in the bottle. Hi-ya-ya-ya-ya. Okay, let's try again. Don't know if I like it as much. See if I have a, let me see if I have a different blue paint. Silver turned out pretty. Oh, let's try this. Let's try this one. This is folk art. Oh, can't get it on camera. Me change that. There. Folk art metallic blue sapphire. See if this gives it the punch I want. Maybe I need a bigger brush, huh? See if this brush, maybe that's why I'm not getting what I want. This is a gorgeous color right here. You see that? No, this is folk art metallics. And this is blue sapphire. Sorry for the glare. Folk art. Just want to, punch of another color in there. See, because I put the gesso on there, I can wipe this back. So I don't want to cover up the me get most of that off my brush, and then I can do like a dry brush. Okay, and then I can go back in. And add back some of that gold that I took out. Okay, I'm gonna let that sit there for a bit. And then I want to add some blue on that. And then some blue on this. I did pour out a little bit too much, but oh, it's so pretty. Can you see that? You see how pretty that is? Okay, so I think I'm pretty much finished with these colors. Okay, so let me clean this up. I think that's what did he find, Carrie Ann? What kind of present did he bring you? I love these silicone mats. This is a Tattered Angels mat. They don't make these anymore. I have Tim Holtz one and I have this one. This was two times the size. I cut it down. So Carrie Ann, what? Oh my gosh, you found a brown snake. Okay. So I didn't put my gloves back on, but this will come off real easy with my Scrubby by Tim Holtz. You know, it's the round gray. Looks like a big emery board. No, Eileen, they don't. They do not. I want to get this off because what I'm going to be working with next, I don't want to have this on my hands. And it comes off real easy. Easy peasy. See, it just peels right off my gel nails. Okie So now, like I said, there's going to be a piece of paper behind here, and then this will set on top like so. So let me get a scrap piece of paper so I can give you a better idea. This paper is from the 6x6 collection of Vintage Emporium by Prima. This is the 6x6 pad. Thank you so much, Eileen. Thank you. I'm glad you like it. Makes me happy. Get it off that pink. There, does that show the colors a lot better? So see, let me just grab a piece of paper that I think would work real pretty back there. This might work. Think I like this better. Yeah. Okay, so just gonna rough cut this with my scissors. So this will sit like that. See? And then this actually, I could take this off. Wait, I might want to leave that on there. I got an idea. Okay. Okay, so that'll sit up there like that. And this will sit like that. Okay. And then I have this little button that set, well, it's not a button. I got it at Hobby Lobby and it says, I am blessed. And I was going to put that right there somehow. So what I'm going to do first is I have glass glitter copper. Art ingredients, and I want to see how that'll be. I think that'll be pretty in there, so I'm going to fill that with I'm going to fill this with glossy accents. Got the wrong, not the wrong tip, but I don't have the wrong tip, but oh yeah, I'm just going to pour it straight from the bottle because I want to put a lot of it in there instead of using the fine tip. Okay, yes, that's a lot. That is true. And now I'm just going to put this in here like this. Okay. I'm going to tap that down. Now, what I'm hoping will work is I can take my tweezers and set that in there, and when it dries, it'll be level. Except it's oozing out down at the bottom. Maybe I ought to wait till that dries before I try to put it in there. Okay, but you'll see, you get the idea, right? So, I like this paper back here, so I'm going to trim it down just a little bit more. Yes, it will be a hard surface, and then I will use glossy accents to put the button. It's not really a button, but this little guy on there. I am blessed. I gotta get that light changed. Can you see? There. I am blessed. Okay, so now I'm going to, let me see how this, do a dry fit. Oops, upside down. Oh, yeah. So I'm going to use glossy accents to put around the paper. That's horrible, Jen. And by you, the glossy accents is better for this than quick dry. So now I can turn that over. And then this will go here, and that will sit there, and I'll put a piece of cardboard behind the heart to help it stand up a little bit. When it's dry. So now what I want to do is I'm going to set this here, and I'm going to set that there, and I had them out here earlier. La la la, what did I do with them? Oh, here they are. So they have these metal embellishments by Prima. They came out in 215, item 583576. And I was wondering how it would look. No, I don't like that. So I'm going to do something that we learned to do in class. I bought these off of Amazon. They're a little rhinestone. It's a rhinestone trim. And what I'm going to do is, we did this in class at Prima Art Venture. And I'm going to see if I can mimic it. So I'm going to set that aside over there. And what we did was we cut these. And then we glued them on to this. So I'm going to try to get as much as that fabric off of there as I can. I'm going to use, again, I'm going to use the glossy accents. And my tweezers. Okay. Oh, you know what? I have these. Let's use these. These are pretty. Not that those aren't pretty. So let me just cut them all so I'll be ready. Maybe I ought to use these scissors. Oh, I'm just cutting rhinestones, but thank you. Sorry about that. Okay. So, let me get the glossy accents ready and get the tweezers. I'll bring you in some. Okay, so I'm putting the glossy accents right here, and then I'm going to pick this up. You don't have to use tweezers, but it works better for me if I use tweezers, except I got some glue on my tweezers, and now it doesn't want to work. There. Okay. And then I'm going to put one over here. You know, I always work in odd numbers. So now, let me see, maybe I'll put another one right up here. One, two, three, four, five. I think it needs two more. I'll put one right here. One, two, three, four. And I'll put one right here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay. So that's that. And now what I want to do is I want to take some of this and move that there. I want to put some of this same thing down in the corners. Thank you so much, Eileen. Thank you, Dorothy. I think she'll like it too. And then I'm gonna put some more over here, or maybe I should put it up here. I love doing this kind of stuff. I'm much better at doing this than journaling. Okay, and then I'm thinking, let me see, this is going to go here, and this is going to go like that. So I'm thinking that maybe I'm just scribbling. And see, that'll set like that, and that will set like that. Thank you, guys. I think she'll love it. And then this little button, I keep calling it a button, will go right there. Just love it. See if I can get that glare off of there. Hold on, don't want to make you sick. See if I can get the oops. I'm trying to get the glare off. There. Let me see. Where did I have it before? Anyway. You get the idea, right? See, now I can press that down in there because it's a little. It's gorgeous. Thank you, Jean. So see, I'll pick it up very carefully. It says, I am blessed. I know the glare is not too good. I mean, the glare is bad. The button says, I am blessed. And then I'll get an easel and it'll sit on the easel So now, let's see what time is it? 5:47. I need a piece of chipboard to put behind here, or I can put foam tape to pop that up a little bit. Okay, I know I'm off camera, so hold on just a minute. Oh yeah, that's perfect. Okay, so I'm gonna peel this off. And hope I don't move it too much. Come back over here, baby. And I'm gonna put that back on there until this dries. But you guys, I'll hold it up, you guys can see. And then I'll use glossy accents to attach those two pieces. Uh-oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Uh-oh, I lost a pretty good bobble. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, no, that's good. Then I need to put a piece back there. Then before I stick it down, I'll use glossy accents between this and the paper. Nope, one more piece. Okay, just a minute, guys, and I'll show you. It's gonna look. Uh-oh. I lost the bobble. I see it. I see it. Okay, let me just get this down in here. Come on now, behave yourself. There you go. Let's put the bobble back on, or the bling, as I call it. On. I don't like it. Looks too symmetry. I don't want too much. There you go. Okay, guys. Oops. There you go. So there we are. I think I might put some ribbon or something here, but I'll have to think about that. So, do you have any questions about any of the products or that I used? I think I used all Prima products. Those are from Prima in their embellishments. Well, I don't know, Jean. I didn't know if I was going to finish in 2 hours. I'm quite surprised. I didn't know if I was going to make it. I wish I could get rid of the glare so you guys could see. Me see. There, that's better. You can find Prima embellishments. Let's see, a cherry on top. Sometimes you can find them on Amazon. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. Sometimes you can find them on Amazon, a cherry on top, Blue Moon scrapbooking. Did I say Amazon? And if you have a scrapbook store near you, that's, a good scrapbook store, they will have them. Oh, she's in the UK. Oh, sorry. Sorry, Dorothy. Sorry about that. It's hard for me to remember who's in the UK and who's in Australia. I know Jen's in Australia. Try Amazon UK. The little rhinestones, those, like, the only difference in those and these is these have the black. This is like for dressmaking, but what I did, as you saw earlier, is I just cut as much of the black off as I could. And I got this one and another one in silver off Amazon for like pennies on the dollar. Of course, you being in the UK, it probably wouldn't be pennies on the dollar. I know it is frustrating when you live in places that either you don't have a store next to you, a local store next to you that would carry the product, or you live in a country where you can't find the product. And then people like me and others, we make things and you want to make them and you can't. Yeah, do what Eileen said. Type in Prima Artifacts and see what comes up. Yeah, I mean, you can use any kind of frame. I just happen to have this Prima frame in my stash, but this frame is, three and I'd say 7/8 by 5. And these pieces are like together, or they are about 5 inches tall, a little short of 5 inches. There's a link, try that. Yeah, I mean, when I went on Pinterest, yes, it did. It did, Eileen. Thank you for posting that for Dorothy. When I went on Pinterest, you can buy like Mod Podge silicone molds, and people had bought those and used paper clay and made some really pretty frames. Or you can, Prima has frames too, but you can use anything that you have that you can use a medium with, air paper, I mean paper, air, dry clay, anything, any type of corner. You could use a basic plain frame and decorate it with different embellishments. Yeah, get some air dry clay like Jean is talking about and some silicone molds and make your own. I saw that a lot on Pinterest and I just happened to have this frame and I thought, this is perfect. I'm going to use this. So I'll use the glossy accents to hook them together. I don't have them glued down right now. And then I still think I'm going to put some type of ribbon or something up there. Like I said, I'll have to think about that, what I'm going to do with it. Oh, you can copy mine. It won't bother me. That's the biggest compliment you can give someone is to copy their work. As long as you tell them, you know, hey, you inspired me and I'm going to copy your work. I don't think anybody really and truly would have a problem, you know, as long as you mention to them, hey, I really like that. Can I make one like it? Absolutely. If you want to make one exactly like this, you are more than welcome to do so. So, okay, ladies, I think that does it for me for tonight. I'll be here again next Monday, which is the 12th. I'll be here on December the 12th, and then Debbie Epps is going to stream for me on December 19th, December 26th, and January the 2nd. And her Ustream channel is Debbie Epps, DEBBYEPPS, DEBBYEPPS. It does remind look like a fancy perfume, doesn't it? Oh, you're welcome, Jean. I can't wait to see how your oh, I do too. Aren't those Mason? Isn't that Mason jar just? Oh, isn't it just gorgeous? I just love how, see how translucent when you look down in there? It really doesn't do it justice on camera. So pretty. So, Kathy Arbor, who is Cass 1415. CASS 1415. I believe she's streaming tomorrow unless we hear otherwise from her. And Xandra will be all rested up from her classes with Diane Wakely, I mean Dina Wakely. And she said she's streaming Wednesday night. And Dee Dee streams Wednesday morning, but way too early for me. Yeah, Jen, that is Mod Podge. Sheer aqua turquoise transparent paint. Okay, guys, well, thank you for joining me. I really enjoyed working on this project, and I think, you know, it's speaks volumes of how the recipient feels. So I'll see you guys on some other streams throughout the week. Oh, Dee Dee is not streaming on Wednesday. She has an appointment. Thank you, Jean. And Debbie Epps will be streaming Wednesday night in Paula's place because Paula's, you know, they got her working like a dog over at Tim Hortons. So Paula's time is 9 o'clock Eastern on Wednesday night. Yeah, I got this from of course Michaels, but it's made by Plaid. So thank you guys for joining me. I'll see you around and about, you know, on the streams later this week, and I hope everyone has a good evening and the rest of a good week. Okay, goodbye now.